Namo Padaya, Lord Krishna, Buddha. পরা জিজ্ঞেস করছে, অ্যানাউন্স করবে কিছু, অ্যানাউন্স।
Oh, ज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनसमाकर चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमो। महाबदन्नाय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरद्विषे गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकाय ददार्यय कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय नमो। यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरहकातरया जुहाव पुत्रेति तन्मयतया तर्वोभिनेदु तं सर्वभूतहृदयं मुनिमान् तोष्मि। त्वैवास्मि तर्वरीवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति प्रीत्याय राधे त्वं नये माम्।
Devotees, what's up, English guy? I would like to ask all those devotees who do not have and want to have a bus ride to the Frankfurt Airport, not the Frankfurt Hahn Airport, to register with Tilak Das. We will try to arrange, or actually will arrange, for a bus or transportation for you to the airport. We just have to know what size bus to rent, so please register as soon as possible, preferably today, with Tilak Raj, so we can order an appropriate bus. Yes, Frankfurt International Airport. Tomorrow there will be a fire yagna just outside the temple room at 10 o'clock, so that means no darshan, right? Darshan is, okay, so darshan will be at the same time inside. 9:30? Okay. Alright, so fire yagna at 9:30. Tunga Vidya Didi invites all ladies at 11:30 to this hall, to the hall entrance actually, for an SIS meeting. It's for ladies only. Please come. If you want to know what SIS is, you will find out when you come. Otherwise, you won't. And another thing, tomorrow evening, before the evening program, we request all the devotees who have brought their deities with them to remove them from the altar there. Tomorrow evening, before the program begins, we would like to ask you to remove the deities, because after the program, we will start taking down the decoration and preparing to bring things to what they were before we had the festival. Thank you.
By millions of dandap pranam in the lotus feet of my Paramaradhatam Guru Pad Padma, Om Vishnu Pasi Smad Bhakti Pragyan Kishore Goswami Maharaj, and same in the lotus feet of my शिक्षा गुरु ओम विष्णु पाद श्रीमद भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी महाराज नव सुखदेव गोस्वामी बिगेन टू टेल ऑल अदर शुड पास टाइम्स विच टू प्लेस वन डे इन ग्रीष्मकाल समर डे व्हेन कृष्ण वाज काउ हर्डिंग द वॉइस बिकेम वेरी वेरी थर्स्टी एंड देयर दे सॉ जमुना वाज फ्लोइंग बट दे डोंट न्यू दैट Now Kali has made this, and then at once some cows and some swans took some water and drank. At once they became faint. Then Krishna saw that. And then by his eyes he looked, and so that Amrit gave nectar, and they again alive. Then he began to think, oh, this is very bad that Kaliya is here. Anyhow, this is very nearer to Vrindavan, so I must do something that Kaliya should go away from here. And then what became?
Chalam Pangumangati Girim Yakipam Tamangam Shiguru in a Tainam, Makian Tiran, the Siakanan Janashalaki, Shakshun Mithin at the Smile Shigurabinama. First of all, I offer obeisance then to the merciful guardians of my poor devotion, Shishinath Bhaktivinoda Swami Prabhupada, Shishinath Gogovinda Goswami Maharaj, and by loving grace, Srila Gurudev. So now we are in Vrindavan, and we have seen that Kamsa, Raja Kamsa, has sent one by one all his henchmen to try to kill Krishna. Now, here we come to another character. He's the only character that Krishna will subdue, which is not sent by Kamsa himself. Kaliya was already there, so he's a unique character there. Now the question can be asked, but why Kamsa himself didn't come? Kamsa was stronger than 10,000 elephants, and why he has sent people one after another? So there is an interesting story. Just prior to Krishna's birth, Kamsa crossed the Jamuna to come to Vrindavan. As soon as he came across, Purnamasi Yogamaya caught him, and she dipped him in the Jamuna, and he came out in the old body of an old lady. Then the gopis came and they gave him all kinds of chores. He had to wash the dishes, he had to do kodam patties. And he was in so much distress, he begged and begged Purnamasi, and she said, one condition, you never come back to Vrindavan. That's why he was sending other people in his stead. That's a little digression. So after sending all those people, still Krishna was doing well in Vrindavan. Then Krishna, after seeing that his friend had been poisoned by Kaliya, he decided something must be done. Now, it's a long, long story. I don't know if I should tell the whole thing. You know that Garuda, the king of snakes, is a natural enemy of the snakes, the king of the birds. Now, he was in, there was a trust made, an arrangement made by the snakes and Garuda. Because Garuda would come, just swoop down on a snake, anyone, and just take him. So they decided, let's make a deal. Every month we'll give you a certain amount of snakes, and you'll just be satisfied with that, and not come and just, ransacking the whole place, killing so many snakes. So the deal was made. But Kaliya was a very crooked snake, and sometimes before Garuda would come, he would come and eat the snakes himself. So Garuda was very, very angry and decided, I will kill this Kaliya. Now Kaliya knew that Garuda, there was only one place in the whole world he couldn't come. That was this Kaliya Rad, this lake in Jamuna. Because previously, Somali Muni had been doing austerities in the Jamuna. And Garuda, not only he eats fishes, he also eats snakes, he eats also fish. So one day he came, and he took the leader of the whole flock of fish. And so Valimuni was doing his meditation there. He kind of felt that he was the well-wisher, the protector of the fish. And the fish were in great distress. So Valimuni took it upon himself to give a curse, even to the bird carrier, great devotee Garuda. So he cursed him. He said, if you ever come back here, you will die. This is a fact. Kaliya was the only one who knew about that. So when Garuda decided to kill him, he thought, oh, only one place I can take shelter of, this place. So he went to Vrindavan, and he took shelter in that Kaliya Rad. Now, because of his nasty nature, actually, among all the obstacles to bhakti, Kaliya represents dvesh, envy, personified malice. You know that Thakur Bhaktivinoda, the seventh Goswami, he has explained that when Krishna appears in Vrindavan, he takes away the mundane conception which is inherent in the conditioned soul's conception of the spiritual world. But not only does he do that, but after he removes one by one all the obstacles to the ecstatic emotions of Braj. So after so many obstacles, then we've come today to the tenth one, which is subduing Kaliya. Kaliya represents malice, envy, dvesh, and we know snake, they're very envious. When I was a young devotee, Prabhupada once told a story that if you kill, in Mayapur there was some cobra was being killed. Prabhupada said, oh, you must kill him and cut his head and pierce his eyes. Because there's so many envious living entities ready to take a snake body. If you don't do that, some other soul will come and then will enter the dead body and it will go on again. No. So snake means envious, enviousness, dvesh, malice. And Kaliya is this personified malice. Now, Mukut Shiromani Gurudev, he has given a very nice purport to that. No, he is the king of all Rasik Vaishnavas. And he has explained a few years ago, maybe some of you remembered, that when Gurudev was given an explanation of Yashumati Nandan Bhajan, he was explaining Yashumati Nandana Brajabharam Nagara Gokula Ram Sanakam. Oh, so much nectar is flowing. Then suddenly, in the middle of a pot of nectar, there is Kaliya Daman. And what does this poisonous snake comes to do in a pot of nectar? But Gurudev, with his Rasik visions, that explained, no, no. This pastime actually is a Purvarag pastime. Krishna wanted to show his prowess to the young gopis. He came in the mood of Dhirodhata, hero, showing his valor, his prowess, his beauty. And he took advantage of that lila to come and dance on a very, very moving platform. We're coming to that now. Krishna was thinking, I have to rid Vrindavan of this rascal poisoning Jamuna. Kaliya was living with his family, his friends, his associates, his children, his wives there. And he had 101 heads, 100 heads of lust, of old friend and enemy that we all know about. All the different varieties of lust, that's 101 heads of Kaliya. And from each head, so much poison was emanating and boiling the water of Jamuna and poisoning everything. To such an extent that you've all read in Krishna book or heard before that even the birds flying above, the water was so poisonous, Ram Nam Satyahe, it would go down in the water. It would be finished. And every creeper, every tree, everything around the lake, Kaliyalad, had been died. Except for one tree, who had received one drop of nectar carried by Garuda in a previous pastime. And that tree was waiting with the hope, how can I do some service for Sri Krishna? Sri Vishwanath Chakravarti Pad explained like this. So Krishna decided, I'm going to chastise that rascal and get rid of him. So he climbed on the tree, tucked his clothes, and swam down, jumped down in the lake. Now Krishna's weight, it is said that when Krishna jumped, the weight of the whole universe was in his stomach, his abdomen, right? So when he jumped inside, the waves, they went to the sky and miles outside, like that. And Krishna started to play in the water, making such a beautiful sound in the splashing the water, playing, that at once Kaliya understood, someone is trespassing in my kingdom. He became very upset. So at once he came and he attacked Krishna. He beat him on the chest and he caught him. And Krishna, at the beginning, he played like he was just an ordinary human boy. After all, this is not about lila, human-like pastimes. And he allowed the snake to catch him within his coils. And for some time he was lying there. Now at the same time when this happened, so many omens, bad omens, started to manifest in Vrindavan. In the land, in the sky, in people. All the court boys start to have their left eye twinkling, which is a bad omen according to Vedic culture. And they all felt something wrong is going on. Or maybe Krishna has been killed. This is very bad. All kind of bad omens were there. So some cowherds were grazing the cows nearby and working in the fields. They came and they saw that Krishna is there in the middle. Then Krishna, their dear, their lala, dear dearer than their life, is within the cords that gigantic snake. So they felt so aggrieved. So immediately they sent the news back to Vrindavan and everyone started to come. And it is said that just by seeing Krishna's lotus feet, there were thousands and lakhs of people, cows, they all came to the bank of the lake. But Krishna's lotus feet are so special that they could trace him among all of these different footprints, hundreds and thousands of footprints. They could see, oh, this is our Lala's footprints, out to the bank of the river. It is said that Mother Yashoda, she was completely mad in anguish. You know that Mother said, Mother Yashoda, her love is so great She can give up millions of bodies just to spare one sweat bead on the forehead of Krishna. So imagine how much anxiety was hers when she saw her darling, no, Lala, Kaniya, within the coil of that gigantic snake. They were trying, the gopis had to catch her, trying, you know, so that she wouldn't jump in the water to try to save him. Everyone was so mad. Balaram had not been there before. That's why they were also so much in anxiety. They were thinking, oh, today Krishna went, but Balaram was not there to protect him. Something must have happened. When Balaram came, he saw Krishna, and he was thinking, usually Krishna doesn't, you know, care to play with me in my form of Ananta sage. But now today, he's playing with this worthless, you know, mundane snake. Let us see what he has in mind. So because he knew that his brother was invincible, Ajita, he was smiling very peacefully. Then by seeing his smile, everyone became a little pacified. Now Krishna decided, I have put them enough anxiety, their love has increased enough now. Because Krishna is always wanting to taste more and more love. After some time, the love is subsiding somewhat. So he's creating some boost so that this love will increase again. And how is he doing that? The usual way that he does. He puts his devotee in great anxiety, great separation. Then they feel so much more love, you know, upsurging, an upsurge of love in their heart. Then Krishna feels, oh, now again, they love me so much. That's because he wants to enjoy the grass. So he's interested in. So Krishna's decided, now it's enough, now their love has come to a good standard again. And now I can enjoy, I can show now my prowess. And then Krishna expanded his body and Kaliya had to let go of him. And at once Krishna jumped on his hood and he started to dance. And all of you who are going to Vajramandal Parikram, you know it is the first day of the Parikram, and every time, or Rasananda Maharaj, he's explaining, chanting how Krishna was dancing on the heads of Kaliya.
Tandava gati mundana paranita sabana mali. Tandava gati mundana paranita sabana mali. Pam 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 pada pada gata pam pam. Pam pada pada gata pam 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 pada pada gata pam 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 pana pau para pam 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 pada pada gata pam 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 pana pau para bing 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 pinata karata bing 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 pinata karata nagabadhu ali. Tandava gati mundana paranita sabana mali. Tandava gati mundana paranita sabana mali. San 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 kartika, san 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 kartika, nam 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 Narada Muni. San 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 kartika, nam 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 Narada Muni. Gan 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 Gandharva gan, gan 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 Gandharva gan, sabayeta sali. Tandava gati mundana paranita sabana mali. Tandava gati mundana paranita sabana mali. Tandava gati mundana paranita sabana mali. Usi Kaliya Nathan Bhagavan ki.
This is written by Surdas.
So maybe in one future lifetime we'll be able to. So Krishna was dancing on the head of Kaliya in such a beautiful, magic, melodious way. And Kaliya was raising his hooves one after another with pride. And Krishna was crushing his pride one after another. So there's some teaching there. Because Kaliya is a representation of malice, tvesh, lust. All this poison boiling in the water, it represents all these anattas boiling in our heart. And just like Krishna was crushing all his heads like that, we pray that in the same way Krishna will appear in our heart and dance in our heart and crush down all our envy or dvesh or lust. So he was crushing down his head. He would dare sometime to raise one. At once Krishna would dance like that. Now imagine dancing on a moving platform like that. You have to be pretty good, right? So Krishna is the best dancer. No, he's the king of all dancers. And then he was displaying his prowess like that to all the little gopi girls. No, and they were all developing this pulvarag, this attachment previous to meeting. Now they were getting a little older. And their love was starting to melt more and more towards the Krishna. So Krishna was fulfilling in one pastime different purposes like that. Then Kaliya started to become more and more weak, and he started his head one by one going down, Krishna crushing, jumping from one another. Very, very beautiful. And all the demigods were showering flowers. Then Kaliya, at the end, he was in such a bad shape, vomiting blood. Now, Krishna's feet were decorated by the light from his different jewels, like Krishna's feet with like copper, illuminated by the jewels. Then the wives of Kaliya, which were very pious, now they had the natural gentle qualities of ladies, then they came forward with their children, and they started to pray, offering very beautiful prayers. And they started to say, we don't know which... After saying, it is very befitting of you to have punished this very sinful person or husband, because he's a very, very bad character. But on the other hand, we are wondering what wonderful activities, what austerities, what pious activity did he do in the past, in the previous lives, that now you are dancing on his head and giving him so much mercy. Now he has become surrendered, he has become a Vaishnava by your mercy. And they offer a very, very beautiful prayer. Now it is said that in the middle of that lake, there was an island. And then Kaliya came to that island, and all the wives around, and Krishna was there also. And they started to offer to Krishna all the jewels in the treasury of Kaliya. Because Krishna was decorated with so many jewelry like that. And they were offering prayers and prayers again and again. And then Krishna told Kaliya that now, this is very good, now you should leave this place and not disturb anymore the inhabitants of Vrindavan. You should go back to where you come from, to the island of Fiji, what is it? Ramanak Deep, where you were before, and don't you ever come back here. What is this? Itaigo, Primanandi, man.
After that, Kaliya returned to Ramanak Deep. But at the time of going, he was praying to Krishna, how I can go? Garuda will again attack me. Krishna told that, no, I have given my footprints on your hoofs. So when Kaliya will, Garuda will see, he will not do nothing. Then he went there. But one thing here, that Sauhari cost Garuda is Bahan of Krishna. Chariot. And by bird, his nature is to take fish.
Snake.
So, he took fish by nature. And he is the parikar of Krishna. So, Sauhari caused him. And then it became very great offense. So, by offending, by causing, Krishna associates what became?
Lusty desire.
A lust come in his heart. And for this, thousand and thousand years naked, he was doing tapasya in astrology, in cold water and other things. But now he came. And by his mystic power, he went to that beautiful and he went to
Mandhata. King Mandhata.
In the palace of Mandhata. He was very powerful king. He had 49 daughters, very beautiful. He went there and told that, I want to marry your old daughters. He told that, he saw that he is old person.
Ugly.
and all his bones are seen, how I can do? Then he told him, you should go to, come to my daughters, and if they like, oh, then can they can marry. Durvasa thought, oh, king is very tricky. He is cheating me. You know that I am an old person. So at once he became so beautiful by his mystic power. And he became, he went there in the palace and all the daughters saw him and became very attached. I will marry, I will marry, I will marry. And seeing this, he made his 49 forms and with each lady he married. And thousand and thousand years he enjoyed sex, but not satisfied. But one day, when sun was going down, I have not done anything for so long time. What I have done? Foolish? I have imagined sex things? And then he began to repent. And then he left all and went to forest and did again austerities. And after that, by the grace of Garuda, he became a devotee. So Vishwa did not criticize any Vaishnav, whether he is Uttam Madhyam. Vishwa try to obey him. If he is angry, even you should know that his anger is for our benefit, his mercy. So we should be very careful. And after that, now it was evening like night. So all the gopis, Nanda Baba, Yashoda and all, thought that village is somewhat far away. We should in night be here. And they began to spend their night there. But in the midnight, Kansen, his one of the demon, go and make fire in the forest. So he all round forest, he made fire and all began to work.
Getting burned.
Then they began to pray Krishna, O Krishna, O Krishna, save us, save us. You have some mystic powers. And then Krishna at once came and took all the fire and everything was subsided. When Kansa saw that, he is not, my enemy is not dying, anyone not doing anything, then Padambasur, very, very strong demon, he sent. And what became?
Om Gyanati Mirandasya. Galanjana Shalakaya Chakshun Mitam Jena Tasmai Shri Gurve Namaha Vanchaka Patrugishta Kripa Sangeva Chapatita Nam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadha Shiva Sarigo Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama Rama Hare Hare. First of all, I offer my most respectful obeisances unto the lotus feet of my Diksha Guru Nityalila Pavishtam Vishnupad, Astuta Rasata Shishimad Shila Gaur Govinda Goswami Maharaj. Again, I offer my most respectful obeisances unto the lotus feet of my Sannyasa Shiksha Guru Vishnupad, Astuta Rasata Shishimad Shila Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj. And again, my most respectful obeisances unto the lotus feet of my Param Gurudevs Nityalila Pavishtam Vishnupad, Astuta Rasata Shishimad Shila A.C. Bhakti Granta Swami Shila Prabhupada and Nityalila Pramishnam Vishnupada Astuta Rasata Shishman Shila Bhakti Pagyan Keshav Goswami Maharaj. on most humble basis is unto all Trinandi sannyasis, Vaishnavas, Vaishnavis. So now it's summer season in Vrindavan, and I'll get right to the pastime. So Kamsa, he sent one very, very powerful demon, his name Pralambasura. So Pralambasura, as these the friends of Kamsa, they have so many mystic powers. So he had this mystic power where he could assume any form that he desired. So Pralambasura, he went in the midst of Krishna, Balaram, and the cowherd boys, and he assumed the form of a cowherd boy, mixing with them, talking, playing. They were going through the forest of Vrindavan, performing so many games. So they decided that they would play hide and seek. So Krishna, he had his group on one side, and Baldev, he had his group on the other side. Pralambasura, being somewhat intimidated by the strength of Krishna, knowing that Krishna had killed so many demons, so then he went and he took the side of Krishna, thinking that he would then be able to attack Baldev. So, playing hide and seek, those cowherd boys, along with Krishna, they would hide, and then Baladev, Sridham, and his friends, his side, they would go in search for Krishna and his friends. So by and by, Baladev and his friends, they found Krishna and all of the different cowherd boys on his side. So as the losers, they had to carry on their back the winners. So then Krishna, he had to carry Sridham, and Baladev, and Pralambasura, he, in the form of a cowherd boy, now he had to carry Baladev. So Pralambasura, he started to take Baladev very, very far direction, away from all the other cowherd boys. Baladev being the Supreme Personality of Godhead, then, though he's playing his Narvat Leela as a young boy, but still, he could understand that, oh, that this is not just some ordinary cowherd boy, but this is actually a demon disguised as a cowherd boy. So then, it's described that Baladev, he starts to become heavier and heavier and heavier and heavier, till he became as heavy as Mount Sumeru. Pralambasura, now, not being able to contain this weight, then he gave up his disguise, and then his natural form manifested, very, very huge form, with ornaments, and very, very ferocious. And then he started to carry Baladev, and started to reach up to the sky. Baladev, very, very easily, with his fist, he just hit Pralambasura in the head. And then he smashed his head and his jaw. He smashed his head, his jaw, and this demon fell to the ground, broken and devastated. And dead. So then, what is the teaching from this pastime? Yesterday, we discussed that Baladev, he represents Akanda Guru Tattva, Gurudev. And now again, not Krishna, but Baladev, he is killing this demon Pralambasura. So this Pralambasura, he represents Kapatya. Is it Kapatya? He represents Kapatya, duplicity. Within duplicity, there's also Kutinati. So Kapatya means, for the sadhak, as I explained yesterday, that having come to the line of, especially this pure line of Srila Rupa Goswami, and coming at the lotus feet of such an exalted personality as Srila Gurudev, that after thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands of births, this chance is there. So I said that better to take birth in the lowest species of lives, worms, ants, birds, than to cultivate kapatya, duplicity, matsarya, envy, kutinati. So, regardless of our situation, then we should practice, especially towards Srila Gurudev, we should practice being straightforward. That what is in the heart
should also be performed externally. That we should not have one thing in the heart and then another thing externally. But the heart should be open and always to reveal our mind to Gurudev. That especially we're coming and Guru is Sadhu Vaidya. He is a transcendental physician. But then the patient has to come and present, okay, oh, this is my sickness. And then the transcendental physician, then he will perform the operation. So it's very, very, very important that always, that our hearts are always open to Srila Gurudev. We may think that, oh, but the sannyasis, they get to travel with Srila Gurudev so much, they can go in, they have so much easy access. But we should understand that Srila Gurudev is not a mundane material personality who is limited by time and space, but that we all have access to that association, and that we have a responsibility, to take advantage of that, right, and develop that heart-to-heart relationship, which means really opening our hearts. And then, kapatya, there's also kutinati. Kutinati means, in this regard, not fault-finding, not criticizing. That Srila Gurudev very, very often, he stresses the point that we should not criticize another person. Even if the person is doing something which is wrong, if we're not in the position, then we should not criticize, we should not fault-find. I believe Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, he gives the example that a sieve, you know a sieve that you use for straining rice, things like that, it has so many holes, and the sieve is looking at the needle and saying, oh look, you have that hole, how bad, how bad, how bad. So we should be concentrated on the anattas which are there within us, rather than concentrated on the anattas or problems of somebody else. Really we should be concentrated on the positive side of engaging in Krishna consciousness, and then these anattas, automatically, they will be eradicated. So, here, by Baladev killing this demon, showing that these anattas, which are very, very difficult to overcome by ourselves, then we need to take shelter of the lotus feet of Srila Gurudev. That we need to take shelter again and again and again, and that this is the backbone of bhakti. Developing this shelter, this mood, this relationship, this nishtha. That once this is there, that relationship is there, then really we can gallop in bhakti. Without this, then we're like horses with broken legs. So we pray to Lord Baladev that please, you are Kanda Guru Tattva, that please be very merciful to me and let me be non-duplicious to all, to Vaishnavas, but most especially to Srila Gurudev. Vancha Kalpa Guru.
Yanatimirandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshurumilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Gurave Gurachandraya Radhikaya Dvadalaya Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Tad Bhaktaya Namo Namaha Vanchaka Patarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhya Eva Cha Patitanam Pavanabhyo Vaishnavabhyo Namo Namaha. So first of all, let me offer my innumerable Dandavat Pranam to those feet of our beloved Gurudev, Srimad Bhaktivedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj, similar obeisances and those feet of Shiva Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, and all our Rupanuga Guru Varga Acharyas, and also Pranam to all the Vaishnavas and Vaishnavis, and our guests and everyone else here. So then there was, what became then? There was a second forest fire. While the Cowherd boys were having the picnic one day at Bandi Rabat, we go there on Parikrama every year, very beautiful place where Shiva Gurudev has sponsored the construction, a very, very nice platform. So they were having the lunch there, and then the cows, while they were having the picnic lunch, the cows and the calves, the cows had wandered away and got lost. So then the cowherd boys went in search of the cows, and they found them stuck in the Munja forest, the forest of bamboo trees, very, very difficult to get out. So they found the cows and they started heading them back out of the forest into the grazing grounds. But then a very big forest fire came, one demon in form of a forest fire came and started, the wind was blowing it very hard and it started eating everything, burning everything. So the cowherd boys became very, very frightened and they were scared. And then what do you do when you're scared? You call on Krishna. Krishna, Krishna, please save me. So they also turned to Krishna and asked and prayed to him, cried to him, please save us, we are being burned. Like we all are being burned in this fire of material existence. So then Krishna said, okay, just close your eyes. So they closed their eyes and Krishna swallowed the forest fire. And when the cowherd boys opened their eyes, they found themselves back. Not only the fire has completely disappeared, but they found themselves back in Vandirvat, sitting and having their picnic just as before, as if the cows had not wandered off and if the whole thing was just an illusion. Similarly, if we trust the orders of Guru, Shri Guru, the representative of Krishna, and trust him to follow what he is asking us to do, also this material existence, the forest fire of material existence, will disappear and we'll find ourselves somewhere else, more appropriate. So now, Bhaktivinoda Thakur in Krishna Samhita, he explains how the 16 demons represent 18 kinds of anattas, which are obstacles for our bhakti. And he explains that this forest fire represents it represents what we call niyamagraha, like in atyahara prayasyascha prajalpa niyamagraha. Niyamagraha has two meanings. One is when we neglect the rules and regulations. Another niyamagraha means when we put too much emphasis on the externals of bhakti, like dress, like ritual, like protocol, and we forget the essence, which that bhakti is an affair of the heart. That bhakti is about love, about how to give our heart to Guru and Krishna. It's not about exactly about having my tilak perfect like this. So this insistence on formalities, we should be careful not to fall into this trap, because these six things destroy our bhakti. And this is one of them. If we forget what the essence of bhakti, the internal mood is not less important than the externals, then we will lose the essence, the flow of bhakti. And then Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati, he fine-tuned these 18, list of 18 anattas and demons that Bhaktivinoda Thakur wrote, and he said these are 18 obstacles for obtaining Viraj Bhav. And he explained in addition to the Niyamagraha, this forest fire represents sectarianism among Vaishnavas. In strife, arguments and disagreements between different groups of Vaishnavas, different sanghas of Vaishnavas. So this intolerance of even other Vaishnavas that have different guru or slightly different mood is very, very bad for our bhakti, because if we cannot even be respectful and friendly to other Vaishnavas from other groups or from other gurus, disciples of other gurus, then if we will criticize them and disrespect them, then we will also in very much danger of losing our bhakti. So this is what the forest fire represents. We have to try and avoid this forest fire, or the only way to avoid it is to take shelter of Krishna, or for us, the representative of Krishna, Shiva Gurudev.
Dear word is go. Cows. They see green grasses. And again, some far away, they see green grasses. So for this temptation, they run away very far away from Krishna.
Keeping Krishna behind.
Here go means also senses. Our senses. If we are not controlling our senses, then eyes running towards very beautiful faces. Oh, this is very beautiful. She is more beautiful. He is more beautiful, like this. And then nose very fragrant, vibrant. She runs there. Our tongue, oh, very delicious, also runs there. So five senses in five things. If you will not control, then they will go far away from Krishna. That is, you will sink in the lust, self-enjoying, and thus you will go very far away from Krishna. At that time, no any means to be saved. Malli, that, oh Krishna, oh Gurudev, oh Baldev Prabhu, save me. Not only by telling, sincerely, with tears and melted hearts, then he will see, and you will see that as we are in Guru. Krishna told to all the gopi, cowherd boys, that, oh, close your doors,
eyes.
Why? That once I took earth in mouth and Yashoda Ma chastised me. Now if I will drink fire in the presence of all, then they may go and tell Mother Yashoda. And then she will beat me. Twist my ears. So he told that, oh, you should close your eyes. And when they close, then at once in a second, all the cowherd boys, they saw that we are sitting on the bank of Yamuna in Bhandirbhat. Cows, they saw that, oh, they are
chewing.
And they forget even that, where we are, what doing? As a dream, they began to think. So if we, in this time, in this way, we are sinking in sex, enjoyment and others, life after life will go away further. Then if we want to sincerely save from this, then call your Gurudev. O Gurudev, O Krishna, save me, save me. Then you will see that, oh, you are not here, you are in Guru Vrindavan. This is the purport. And after that, Sarad Ritu came. And Sukadeva Goswami is telling, Ittam Satchajalam Padma Karasugandina Namasat Vaivna Bhatam Sago Gopaluko Achyuta. When autumn season comes, all the water in Yamuna, in Mansi Ganga, Kusum Sarovar, everywhere becomes very, very pure, automatic, nothing to do anything, automatic. And Padmakar Sugandhina, so many kinds of lotus flower in there, with very, very beautiful fragrance. And by this fragrance, attracted bees, they began to come, take honey and to honey there. Beautiful Vrindavan. Everywhere, green and green. Kripas have
surrounded
trees. And trees and creepers are full of flowers and full of fruits.
So, air coming from Jamuna, very cool, and with flowers coming, so fragrance was there. And in this way, beautiful Vrindavan, Krishna with Baladev and other gopis entered with cows. Kusumita Banaraj Sushum Venga, Dijikulu Ghushta Sarah Saran Mahidram, Madhupatu Avagaya Sharyanga, Sagopala Ko Achyuta. In this way, that beautiful in Vrindavan, where all kinds of belly, chaveli, jui, kadamba, lotus or flowers are in bhujam, and mad bees are hanging everywhere, and all the rivers, Mansi, Ganga and Jamuna and others, and Giriraj Govardhan was very, very beautiful. And then Madhupati Avagarya Charyanaga, Madhupati Krishna, very sweet, Madhuram Madhanam, Baduram Badanam, like this Krishna. Grazing cows, he entered in Vrindavan and playing on the fort. All his friends, tad brajasthi asrutta venu gītam smarudayam kachit parukkam krishnam sasvakyadhyan parnayan. When the gopis from their houses, far away, they heard the beautiful sound, very sweet sound of floor, at once they began to think about Krishna, his beauty, how he walks, how beautiful smiling, how he walks like elephant, and how he talks with cheeky way. And so thus our he is taking our hearts. In this way, when they heard, at once their love and affection from Krishna, for Krishna, oh, it went extreme, out of their control. And then they began to speak with other gopis, O Sakhi, O Sakhi. Oh, Krishna has done, and playing on flute, but they could not tell. When they began about Krishna playing flute in the forest, at once Marudayam, oh, that love and affection, oh, went very beyond limit. And by this their voice was shocked, tears in eyes, and they become like, oh, senseless. What they saw from there? Varaha pidam natavar vapu karnayo karnikar bibhrat vasa kanak kapisam vai jayanti chamalam randhran venu rathar sudaya purayan gopabinde vrindarandam sabadaramanam pravisati. Oh, they saw, Sukadeva Goswami is telling, they saw Krishna from there. Pitiful body, like clouds. And in clouds, like bijli, flashing light. As if that his Pitambar was. Very beautiful looking. And Banmala up to feet, from here, neck to feet. And Karniyo Karnikaram, he has one flower that is
yellow color,
became Kalki. Very beautiful, very also fragrant. Malivan. Sometimes here, sometimes here. So like mad, unparalleled beauty. Ranthana Venu, and he was playing on flute. What? Cling. And this melody, in this world, no one must to qualify to hear. So, it went on. Even in Swarg, nothing. Across the Vaikunth, and then went to Braja. And only these gopis are hearing, who are most beloved of Krishna. Not Mother Yashoda, not other gopis, not other gopis, not cowherd boys, who there were with Krishna, only they are hearing. But these are hearing with very, very. And then Randhan Venu, then gopi heard, and then become mad. And all the cowherd boys, praising Krishna, O Sakhe life, and his glorifying. And Krishna has so many, 19 kind of chakra,
lotus
and so many dhanus, bow, arrow, so many things.
Auspicious marks.
And he's, well,
walking
on the earth. So, hearing all these things, then gopis began to tell each other, Paroksham Krishna. Krishna was not there, but he was far away in the forest. But yet they are telling, what? Aknatam phalamidam na param vidama. Shakka pasun anvivesh yator bayaschei baktram prajesh sutayo anuvenu vesham jaivan pitam anurakta pitam. Oh, I will speak in Hindi, and he or Prem will translate. O Sakhi, in aankhon ka rehna wahi sarthak hai jo Krishna gocharan karne ke liye ja rahe hain. और घर की सब गृहस्थी छोड़कर पति इत्यादि को छोड़कर मन में जाकर कृष्ण के को दर्शन करें, उनकी मधुर बंसी को श्रवण करें और आंखों से उनके सुंदर रूप को देखें, इसे बढ़कर के और कोई बढ़कर के आंखों की सार्थकता नहीं है. सो वी मस्ट गो. Then another newly coming, कोई नवीन गोपी आकर के कहती है, सखी, हमारे सास ससुर हैं, हमारी ननद है, उनके सामने कृष्ण के सामने कैसे जाएं? ये तो असंभव है. ओह, तुमको नहीं जाना पड़ेगा. कृष्ण का रूप देख लेने से, उसकी बंसी श्रवण करने से अपने आप उसके तरफ में खींच जाएगी. जरूरत नहीं है कोई चेष्टा करने. चलो देख तो लो एक बार. कजे से ननद बिगड़ेगी, बिगड़ने दो. फिर तो ऐसा रूप नहीं मिलेगा दर्शन करने के लिए. फिर कहती है कि देखो, कृष्ण और बलदेव जा रहे हैं, आगे आगे बलदेव प्रभु चल रहे हैं. क्योंकि वो रसिक थे, जानते थे हमारे सामने गोपियों की तरफ नहीं देखेंगे, इसलिए आगे चले गए और पीछे कृष्ण बंसी बजा रहे हैं. आंखें कहां है? वेयर? ओ वेयर गोपीज आर माई मोस्ट बिलव्ड. उस समय में बक्त्रम ब्रजेश सुतयो अनुबेनु जिष्टम. बत्रम ब्रजेश सुतयो, हियर ब्रजेश सुतयो टू बलदेव एंड कृष्ण बोध. कृष्ण एंड बलदेव दोनों ही नंद बाबा के ही मानव पुत्र हैं. उनमें जो पीछे पीछे बंसी बजाते हुए आ रहा है, उसका मुख दर्शन करने से, आगे वाले का नहीं पीछे वाले का। और दूसरा अर्थ होगा ब्रजेश सुतोयो, ब्रजेश टू ब्रजेश, दो ब्रज के ईश है, एक नंद बाबा और एक विश्व भानु बाबा। सुतश्च सुतयो,
सुतयो
या सुता ओ राधिका, जो ब्रजन भानु के जो पुत्री है राधिका जी, उनके साथ में जब भी कृष्ण हो और उस समय में कृष्ण का मुखारविंद देखा जाए और बंसी बजाए हुआ देखा जाए, तो ये आंखें सफल हो जाएंगी। ओ यू शुड स्पीक व्हाट इज मीन।
गुरु रे गौर चंद्र वारे काय तरारे कृष्ण कृष्ण भक्त भक्त नमो नम। Therefore one gopi is saying, O Sakhi, O friend, those eyes are successful that see the beauty of Krishna. Therefore, give up, giving up all household chores, giving up relations with their husbands. Their eyes thirst for the darshan of Krishna, and their ears thirst to hear the sound of Krishna's flute. Those eyes that have seen Krishna, and those ears that have heard the flute, those eyes and ears are successful. Then one new gopi may say, but our mother-in-law is here, our relatives are here, how would it be possible to neglect them and to go for the darshan of Krishna? Then the other gopi said, yes, this is not good for you, you should not go. It is not necessary at all. Because if your eyes one time see the beauty of Krishna as he goes to the forest, then your mind will be caught forever. Then that gopi said, let's go, let me see one time. Therefore, Krishna and Balaram together are going into the forest. Balaram is ahead because Balaram is Rasik. He knows that if he is there, then can be no nice meeting with Krishna and the gopis. Therefore, he is moving ahead. And where is Krishna looking? His eyes are there, glancing at the gopis. Therefore, Sri Sukadev Goswami says, Brajesh Sutayo. One meaning of Brajesh Sutayo means the two sons of Brajesh, means the controlling, the controller or the king of Vrindavan. So in one sense, this verse means the two sons of Nanda, Krishna and Balaram. What? But the gopis are saying, not that one in front, not Balaram, but behold the beauty of that one behind, that is Krishna. But another meaning here, Brajesh Sutayo. There are two Brajeshes. One is Nanda Baba, the king of Vrindavan, and the other one is Vrishabhanu Maharaj. Therefore the gopis are saying, Brajesh Sutayo, those two sons, those two children of Nanda and Vrishabhanu Maharaj. Who is the daughter of Vrishabhanu Maharaj? Radhika. Who is the son of Nanda Baba? Krishna. Therefore those eyes which have seen Radha and Krishna together, those eyes are successful.
Then again, Chuta Praval Barahasta Kotpalabhya. Krishna is very beautiful. O Sakhi, Krishna is very beautiful. He decorated with valli flowers of Vrindavan, Banwala, and very soft red leaves of mango and others. And he has colored his body with Govardhan red color. And thus he has peacock feather here, also some green and very soft leaves of trees, and thus he becomes very, very beautiful, attractive, as if he is Natavara on the Rangamanch.
On the stage you want to make some...
जैसे Rangamanch पर नट आकर के नृत्य करते हैं, अथवा नटवर जिस प्रकार से विवाह के समय में दूल्हे को सजा दिया जाता है, और बहुत ही काला भी व्यक्ति भी बड़ा सुंदर बन जाता है, और कृष्ण तो सुंदर है ही है, इसलिए चलो चलो जाकर के कृष्ण को दर्शन करें. What? Oh, you.
Just like an artist on the stage, he dresses very wonderfully and he's covered with red color as he performs his dance. Then what you speak of Krishna, he is already beautiful, therefore covered by the color of Govardhan. With a peacock feather on his head, how attractive he looks. Chalo Sakhi, let's go and have, see the beauty of that Krishna.
Another meaning of Natavad, during the marriage ceremony of Vedic culture, they decorate the bride room so nicely, even one very black and ugly. They dress makeup so nicely, become attractive. None can understand that he is the same person as before we have seen. This is another meaning of Natavad. Hare Krishna.
गोप्याख्यम आचरत एम कृष्णस्म वेणु दामोदराधर सुधाम गोपिका नाम भोक्त स्वयं यदवर्षी सरसंग्यम हिस्तो मोमो सुस्तर हो जाता. वेरी गुड श्लोक. गोप्या ओ सखी दि गोपी हाउ हाउ दिस वेणु वेणु मीन्स बांस
बैम्बू
What? कैसी तपस्या अद्भुत की है.
What austerity has done as part of
और उसने क्या किया है हम नहीं जानती हैं. जानेंगी तो हम भी वैसा ही कर करके कृष्ण को दर्शन करेंगी. ओहो ये बंसी पुरुष हो करके भी वेणु और हम जो गोपियां हमारा ये धन कृष्ण का अधर है अधर रस और ये हमारे सामने ही हमारे कृष्ण के अधर रस को हमको अंगूठा दिखलाकर और पी रही हैं. हमारे ये तनिक भी नहीं छोड़ा. ओहो देखो तो तालाब हिदन्य तालाब इत्यादि देखते हैं कि हमारे ये पुत्र है कौन बंसी वेणु हमारे रस को पी करके बड़ा हुआ है. बड़े खुश हो रहे हैं जो हमारा पुत्र हमारा वंशधर वेणु कृष्ण के अधर रस को पी रहा है और जो वृक्ष हैं देखते हैं कि वो हमारे वंश में ही ये जन्म हुआ है इसलिए बड़ा सौभाग्यशाली हम लोग हैं. और ऐसा सोच करके कृष्ण को देख करके बड़े आनंदित हो रहे हैं. इस प्रकार से चलो ऐसे कृष्ण को हम दर्शन करें.
Therefore the gopis are asked, Gopya Kimacharat I am, Kusurum Smarenu. Oh, what austerities that flute has done. If we know what austerities he has done, we could also do the same austerities and always be in the hand of Krishna. But alas, that flute is, he is a male. He has no right to drink the nectar of Krishna's lips. We own that nectar, only we should drink it. But that flute is showing his thumb, neglecting us and drinking it right in front of us. In fact, he's not even leaving us one drop. That time the ponds are feeling very happy. Like mother, oh, by drinking my water, that flute became great to become an associate of Krishna. And the trees are also very happy. Oh, look, he is in our dynasty. How fortunate we are. Thus Krishna gave happiness to the residents of Vrindavan.
Oh, Vrindavan, prithvi ki shobha hai. और इसकी प्रतिष्ठा तो आज स्वर्गलोक की बात क्या बैकुंठ से भी अधिक है जहाँ पर श्री लक्ष्मी जी कुंजों को सजाती हैं और सेवा करती हैं. सो देवकेशु कृष्ण हियर ओ यहाँ नित्य कर रहे हैं अपने चरणों के साथ में उनके चरण के चिन्ह पृथ्वी पर आ रहे हैं. ओहो कृष्ण की बंसी ध्वनि सुन करके उनकी ताल पर ताल मयूर नृत्य कर रहे हैं और प्रसन्न होकर के अपने एक पूंछ को छोड़ देते हैं कृष्ण के लिए पुरस्कार देते हैं. और कृष्ण मानो जो तुम इतना सुंदर बजा रहा है बंसी जिस पर हम थिरक करके नृत्य कर रहे हैं इसलिए वो मयूर अपना एक पूंछ देता है कृष्ण को और कृष्ण लेकर के ओ मैं सौभाग्यवान हूँ पुरस्कार को यहाँ पर रख रखते हैं. ओ देखो तो यहाँ पर गोवर्धन की तराई में और जितने पशु पक्षी हैं यहाँ सभी मुग्ध हो रहे हैं और वहां पर चुपचाप बैठ करके मयूर का नृत्य और कृष्ण की बंसी के ध्वनि को सुन करके मुग्ध और पागल हो रहे हैं। चलो
ओ रियली दिस Vrindavan is the crest jewel of beauty of this earth. What to speak of this earth? Vrindavan is even more attractive than the heavenly planets, or even more attractive than Vaikuntha. Thus, when Devakisuta, the son of Yasoda, he plays on his flute, that time the peacocks also, they keep rhythm to Krishna's dancing. That time they want to reward Krishna with his wonderful flute playing. Therefore, they offer their peacock feathers to Krishna. And Krishna thinks, I am so lucky, so fortunate to get such a nice donation. And Krishna places it on his head. Therefore, Sakhi, look towards Govardhan. All the birds there are seeing the flute, the dancing of the peacocks and the playing of Krishna's flute. They have become maddened and stunned.
Oh, Banki Hiraniya dhanya hai. Jati se murkha hai. किसने मूर्ख किसी मधुर तान को सुन करके और अपने शरीर को भी छोड़ देती है, बहेली आकर के उनको मार डालता है, ऐसी मूर्ख है। किंतु आज वो धन्य है कृष्ण के इतने सुंदर मधुर रूप को दर्शन करके और उनकी वेणु का वादन सुनकर स्वर सुनकर के आज दौड़ करके गोपियों जो हम जैसे ही कृष्ण के पास आती हैं और आंखों से प्रणय की कृष्ण की आरती उतारती हैं और कृष्ण भी उनको उसी प्रकार से प्रणय से देखते हैं। ये गोपियां कितनी धन्य है। हम लोग कैसी हैं दुर्भागा, हम तो पति सुनेंगे तो हमको डांटेंगे, आने नहीं देंगे कृष्ण के पास। और ये हिरणियां अपने पतियों के साथ में, पति उनके पीछे, चलो हम भी चलते हैं, कोई चिंता नहीं, तुम कृष्ण का दर्शन करो, उनको सहायता करते हैं। और हमारे पति तो हमारे विरुद्ध आचरण करते हैं, हमारा जन्म होता सार्थक यदि हम हिरणी होकर के जन्म ग्रहणते और कृष्ण के साथ में ऐसे ही दर्शन करते।
Oh, how fortunate even are the deer, the foolish deer. By birth they are completely stupid. Because the nature of a deer, by hearing any flute sound, they are attracted and killed by the hunter. Therefore, really, they are foolish. But today, even they have become fortunate by hearing the beautiful sound of Krishna's flute and by taking darshan of his beauty. Therefore, they run towards him with their husbands and with their glancing of eyes. And Krishna also glances towards them. They exchange aartis. Therefore, the gopis said to one another, we are most unfortunate. If our husbands even so much as think that we are thinking of Krishna, they chastise us and punish us. But these deer are so fortunate, they go with their husbands to Krishna. Their husbands are helping them, not obstacles. Therefore, we hope that next we can take birth as gopi, as deer, because they are supremely fortunate.
Oh, gaya ko to dekho, Krishna ki madhur bansi sunkar और उनके मधुर रूप को दर्शन करके घासें चर रही हैं, घासों का चरना मुख में घास लगी, उसको बाहर भी नहीं फेंक रही है, नीचे भी नहीं निकल पा रही, आनंद से उनके आंख के आंसू बरस रहे हैं। और उनके बछड़ों को तो देखो, उन गायों का दूध पी करके मुख में रखे हैं, न निगल सकते हैं न उगल सकते, और कानों को खड़ा करके गाय और बछड़े दोनों ही कृष्ण के बंसी के स्वर को का रस कानों से पान। ओह धन्य है ये।
ओ द काउज ऑफ वृंदावन आर फॉर्चुनेट, देयर इयर्स दे ड्रिंक द नेचर ऑफ कृष्णस फ्लूट एंड बाय आईज दे सी द ब्यूटी ऑफ हिज फॉर्म। दोज काउज बिकम स्टंड बाय दैट स्वीटनेस, देयरफॉर द ग्रास इन देयर माउथ नीदर फॉल्स आउट nor goes inside their stomach. They remain stunned. Oh, the calves are also like that. They are not drinking the milk. Thus, with the cows and calves both, with their ears upraised, they drink the nectar of Krishna's flute. How fortunate they are.
Oh, is banke pakshi
पक्षी नहीं है, ये तो मुनि है, ऋषि मुनि है, और ये पेड़ों की डाल पर बैठे हुए हैं। पेड़ों की डाल अर्थात वेद की शाखा, उपनिषद इत्यादि शाखाओं पर नहीं, गोपाल तापनी इत्यादि जहां पर कृष्ण की मथुर लीलाओं का वर्णन किया गया, उस शाखा पर बैठ करके और ध्यान से सुन करके सुनते हैं ये, और अपने को सबको कुछ भूल जाते हैं। आंख बंद करके कान से मधुर बंसी का स्वर वो दर्शन करते हैं, आप कृष्ण के रूप को आलिंगन करते हैं।
Oh, just see, even the birds are fortunate. Actually, they are not birds, but really they are great rishis, munis and sadhus. They are sitting on the branches, hearing Krishna's flute. But really, these are not branches. These are branches of the Vedas. And not the ordinary dry Vedic scriptures, but those Upanishads which describe the beauty of Krishna's seva, like the Gopal Tapani Upanishad. Those birds with their eyes closed, hearing the nectar of Krishna's flute, they have forgotten everything in this world, and within their hearts they have darshan and embrace Krishna.
Aur inki to baat kya? Jamuna bansi ki swar sun karke aisi ho jati hai, unka chalna band ho jata hai, pravah band ho jata hai. ऊपर से पानी आता है, नीचे का जाता नहीं, भौंरे पड़ जाती हैं, और उन भौंरों से कृष्ण को आलिंगन करना चाहती हैं, किंतु कृष्ण निरपेक्ष रहने से वो लज्जित होकर के नीचे चले आती हैं, और अपने लहर रूपी हाथों से कमल के पुष्प लेकर के कृष्ण के चरणों में उपहार दे रही हैं। ओहो, ये जमुना नदी धन्य है, हम कृष्ण का आलिंगन नहीं कर सकते, किंतु ये करती हैं।
What you speak of the birds being fortunate, even inert things like Yamuna are fortunate. Hearing the sound of Krishna's flute, she has become stunned. She cannot go from that place. But the water is flowing down, therefore she moves in a whirlpool shape. Thus, by her arms, she wishes to embrace Krishna, but she is also shy. Therefore, her arms in the form of waves, she offers lotus flowers to the feet of Krishna. How fortunate she is.
Oh, Purna Pulinda Urugaya Padapya. Oh, ye Govardhan ki Pulindiya kitni saubhagyavan hai. Jo Krishna ke prati atyanta lubdha hai. कभी कभी गोपियां इन लोगों को बुलाती हैं, वो फूल इत्यादि दे जाती हैं, जिसे वो हार गूंथती हैं, कृष्ण को देती हैं। ये पुलिंदिया उनकी सहायता करती हैं, इसलिए उनको कृष्ण के प्रति प्रेम हो गया। जब वो देखती हैं ये कृष्ण वन के ऊपर में घासों पर चले हैं, और गोपियों के कुमकुम का दाग कृष्ण के चरणों में लग गया, और फिर वही कुमकुम घासों के ऊपर में लग गया, वो प्रेम से दर्शन करके काम से मोहित हो जाती हैं, और उसको पूछ करके अपने सिर पर अपने शरीर में लगा करके काम के ताप को दूर करती हैं। ओ, हम तो ऐसा नहीं कर सकते, किंतु ये कुमकुम गोपियों के ही चरण हस्ताक्षर होता है, ये भूल गई, और कहते हैं ये पुलिंदी तक भी कृष्ण से प्रेम कर सकती है और हम नहीं, हम दुर्भाग्य
हैं। ओ साकी, इवन द पुलिंदियस मींस द एबोरिजिनी जंगल लेडीज ऑफ गोवर्धन, इवन दे आर मोर फॉर्चुनेट देन अस। हाउ ग्रीडी दे आर फॉर कृष्णा। समटाइम्स द गोपीज गेट फ्लावर्स, जंगल फ्लावर्स ऑफ दोज पुलिंदियस, देयरफॉर दोज पुलिंदियस गेट दे सर्व द गोपीज एंड गेट कांटेक्ट विद देम। देयरफॉर द कुमकुम फ्रॉम द बॉडीज ऑफ द गोपीज has come on the feet of Krishna. And that has stained the grass of Govardhan. Seeing that kumkum covered grass, then the Pulindia ladies become absorbed in kam and then in prem. And taking that kumkum upon their face and head, their lust is completely destroyed. How fortunate are those Pulingas? That time the gopis have forgot. Their glory, the kumkum which they are describing, is factually their own, coming from their own bodies.
Oh, ये गिरिराज गोवर्धन निर्जीव पत्थर पहाड़ नहीं है, ये तो हरिदासों में भी सबसे श्रेष्ठ है। एक हरिदास युधिष्ठिर महाराज, दूसरे उद्धव, और दोनों से ही श्रेष्ठ ये गिरिराज। क्यों? क्योंकि सब समय इनके ऊपर में राम और कृष्ण के चरण पड़ते हैं, उसका स्पर्श करते हैं, और गायों के साथ में, सखाओं के साथ में पीने के लिए स्वच्छ मधुर पानी देते हैं, मधु देते हैं और पानी देते हैं और कंदराएं देते हैं खेलने के लिए, बैठने के लिए सिंहासन देते हैं। ओहो, ये गिरिराज जी धन्य हैं। ओहो, ये कृष्ण गायों को लेकर के सखाओं के साथ में एक वन से दूसरे वन में जाते हैं, ऐसी सुंदर बंसी बजाते हैं, और सिर पर गौओं को बांधने के लिए पैरों में दूते समय उसको नोनी कहते हैं, एक को सिर पर बांध रखा है और दूसरे को गले से लगा, जैसा कि ग्वाले करते हैं। उनको देख करके चलने वाले जड़ हो जाते हैं और जड़ जो है वो चेतन हो जाते हैं। धन्य ऐसा कहते हुए कृष्ण का कि बंसी का, बेणु का की प्रशंसा करते करते एकदम तन्मय हो गई।
दिस गिरिराज, ही इज नॉट अ स्टोन, ही इज रियली द बेस्ट सर्वेंट ऑफ कृष्ण, हरिदास वर्जो। वन सर्वेंट ऑफ हरि इज युधिष्ठिर महाराज, but superior to him is Udavji, but superior to them is Giriraj Govardhan. Why is he the best servant of Krishna? Because Ramakrishna Charana Sparsabhika promoted her. Because the feet of Ram means Balaram, and Krishna, their feet always touch him, therefore he is always in ecstasy. How he serves Krishna and Balaram, as well as the cows and the cowherd boys, by supplying water, honey, caves. He supplies stone singhasan or seats for their pastimes. He is most fortunate. Therefore, as Ram and Krishna, Balaram move one forest to another, playing a flute. The rope for binding the head of the cows, one is on their head, and another is around their neck like a mala. How beautiful they are! Seeing them, even the inert objects become Chaitan, become conscious, and the conscious living entities become unconscious or become stunned. Such is the beauty of Krishna in the forest.
After that, Krishna one day, with his cows and friends, he went in the middle of Mathura and Vrindavan. There only Ashok tree, no fruit, nothing. And thus in midday, all the boys were hungry. And they requested Krishna Baldev, oh, you should save me from this demon, hunger. And at once Krishna told, go to this Brahmin very nearby, and you should ask that Krishna and Baldev has come here and they are so hungry. Please give something. Some bhar.
Rice.
Cooked rice or anything. But they never gave. They went there. But they
neglect.
Even did not ask anything the why you have come. They requested again and again, you must give something. But they never gave. Then returned back. Oh Krishna, we will not go anywhere. You should manage anything. Then he told, for beggar, he can go this door, that door. Somewhat, some will praise you, some will
abuse you.
So nothing for this. You should go to their wives.
they must give something. And they again went there and told, Krishna and Baldev has come here and they are very hungry, so please give something for Krishna. Hearing this, they had from before a very love and affection for Krishna. They have heard from others, so they wanted to meet and to take darshan of Krishna. Now, when they heard that Krishna Baldev, oh, they have come to our doors and asking for preparations, and they at once took in big plates so many delicacies of malpua, puri, kachauri, anna, so many things. And they came to Krishna. But some were coming and their husband came and, where you are going, don't go. And they closed in the house. But they went first than these
Brahmanis,
and they met Krishna. And these, when they, they saw Krishna, beautiful Krishna. Shyamang Hiranya Patidham Banavalya Varaha, as it has been told before. And they became so attracted. Then Krishna told, oh, I am Supreme Lord, you have come to see me. Now you have seen me. I am very happy and satisfied. Now surely you should return back. They told, we cannot go. Our heart is here. And if you will return, or husband, father, mother, anyone will not accept me. So, better we will be your maid servant. But we don't want to go. Then Krishna told and thought that they are Brahmin. How I can be with them? I should respect Brahmin. Otherwise, marjada will be bhanga. Otherwise,
etiquette will be broken.
So he told, you should go, your husband will praise you and accept. And then they returned back and their husband told, oh, how fortunate they are. They have not read Vedas, no any auspices, nothing. And they went to Supreme Lord and took darshan, and we,
Fie on me.
We could not go for the fear of cancer. And thus lamenting. And they honored their
wives.
After that, Govardhan. And
drama ache. Sata naam announce korte hobe ekhono.
After that, how Krishna crushed the Abhiman of Indra.
Proud of Indra.
And he took on his left finger Govardhan Giriraj and said all. You. Pulata Galdi Neta. Oh, he is preparing for 7 days. But he is thinking that Maharaj should request him again and again.
Because Krishna lived at Govardhan for 7 days, and also living in Vrindavan, so he needs 7 days to describe.
Don't make it at once.
Om Agyanak Miram Dasya Jnana Indyana Salakaya Chakshur Unmilitam Jena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha Gurave Gaura Chandraya Radhikaya Istadalai Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Tad Bhaktaya Namo Namaha Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sri Vasadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Bolo Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare.
First of all, I am offering my obeisances to my Gurupad Padma, Nithalila, Pravishnu, Vishnupad, Ashtodara Sadasri, Sri Srimad Bhakti Sri Rup, Sri Brihanti Goswami Maharaj. Then after my obeisances, thousand and thousand obeisances offered to my Siddha Gurudev, Paribrajika Acharya Tridandi Swami, Sri Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Narayana Goswami Maharaj. And then after every sannyasis, Vaisnava and Vaisnavis, offered my obeisances. This is my pastime. I try to speak some English in the Harikatha, so you don't accept my any word. You are try to accept my mood. Okay. Vrindavan Das Thakur has told, "Ek kaj kare na Prabhu kaj kare paanch saath." This meaning is the, by one activities he does many activities. This meaning, Krishna, when he carried this Giriraj Govardhan, there are so many reasons. Is the main reason is the Krishna topmost pastime is the Rasa Lila. Now he wants to perform this Rasa Lila. But this Rasa Lila is the topmost Rasa Lila. But without Radharani and the Braj Gopi, Krishna cannot did this Rasa Lila. Now anyhow, Krishna now he attract to Srimati Radharani and Braj Gopis. Why? Krishna is the not Raseswar. Raseswari in Srimati Radharani. Even Krishna still there, all Braj Gopi is there. But when Radharani is left Rasa Lila, Krishna cannot do Rasa Lila. Then all Rasa is the broken. So without Radharani and Braj Gopi, Krishna cannot perform this Rasa Lila. So now Krishna wants to sell such a pastime to Braj Gopi and Radharani and attract this mind. So now this Giriraj Govardhan, Krishna is carrying this Giriraj Govardhan. This is the main point. Yeah. And another point is the Krishna, he wants to teach to us who is the spiritual life and what like this Brajavasi. They cannot worship any demigod and demigoddess. Only our worshipper deity, only he is the Giriraj Govardhan. Yeah. And without Giriraj Govardhan, any person they cannot give us this Braj Prem and the mood of this Gopi's mood and this Anarpita Charanchriyata Prem. Like this Uddhav, Sri Uddhav, he also when he came to Braj and when he understand Braj Gopi's mood is the topmost mood. Then, now he wants this mood of Gopi's. But now he thinks, how can my desire become fulfilled? He saw, without Giriraj Govardhan, mercy of Giriraj Govardhan, my desire cannot fulfill. So even Uddhav, he is the Premadur devotee, Premadur Bhakta, but he takes the shelter of Giriraj Govardhan and he takes the form of grass and he also did austerity. Even in Narad, when he heard to Shankar this Ashtagaliya pastime, he also wants this mood of gopis. So he thinks, how can I get this gopis mood? Then he told, he can go to Brinda and Parnavasi Devi. And when asked to Brinda and Parnavasi Devi, they are also give instruction. Well, without mercy of Giriraj Govardhan, cannot attend this Braj Prem. So you also take the shelter of this Giriraj Govardhan, you also perform this bhajan. So Narad, even Narad, he also takes shelter of Narada Kunda, he also do Varsi. Our Raghunath Das Goswami, he also told, Pramad Madan Lila Kandara Kandarati, Rachayitana Vajunda Mana Maspit Dwanda. Itikila Kalanartha Lagna Sadhvarame, Nija Nikat Nivasade, He Govardhana Purnatva. Raghunath Das Goswami, he is the, Rati Manjari. He also telling, O Giriraj Govardhan, when you give shelter, you have lotus feet. Sanatana Goswami, he also, every day he go to Giriraj Govardhan, he also doing parikrama. Our Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, Jeev Goswami, everybody there take the shelter of Sri Giriraj Govardhan. Now, Krishna want reestablished, if somebody wants this Braj Prem, they must worship Giriraj Govardhan. So, Krishna wants to stop this Indra Puja and he wants to start to this Giriraj Govardhan. And another thing, Krishna he think, Indra he think, oh this Brajavasi is the mind, this Praja,
subject.
They are my subject. Yeah, if I not give rain, they became, you know, hungry. You know, they cannot do anything. But Krishna is thinking, you know, who is the give post of this Indra? When I the Bhamana avatar, that time he give this post of Indra. Give the post of, you know, Indra. But he think is Brajavasi is, he is the my
subject.
But who is the this Brajavasi is? This Brajavasi is not an ordinary person. My own expansion, you know. Ananda Chinmaya Rasa Pratibhavitavi. Radharani is not different to me. And all Brajagopi is that, you know, their expansion of Srimati Radharani. Baladeva Prabhu also expansion to me. And this Sakha is not different to me. And this mother and father, I am carrying the Nanda Baba, soothe my head. And my mother Yashoda catch my ear and will sit down and get up and sit down. You know, he complete by bind my love and affection. But now Indra is thinking, oh, this Brajavasi is my subject. I am is the, you know, I am the master of this Brajavasi. How is the, you know, how is the proud? So many way, yeah, now he want to establish the Giriraj Puja. So one day, Krishna he saw Mother Yashoda whole night. She make many kind of a preparation. Laddu, kachori, malpua, you know, many kind of sweets. Then Krishna went to Mother Yashoda, like, oh, mother, oh, why whole night you are making so many preparations? Oh, tomorrow is my birthday? No, you are not birthday. He go to Nanda Baba. This is Dao Bhaiya's birthday. Well, no, you can go to Nanda Baba. Now Krishna came, sit the left of Nanda Baba, carry this beard, well, Baba Baba. Why whole night Mother Yashoda, my Mother Yashoda, she makes so many preparations. Then Nanda Baba told, you want to worship to Indra Devata. Then Krishna asks, why you want to worship to Indra Devata? Well, oh, he is the master of rain. If he not gave rain, you are the, you know, cowherd person. When he gave rain, then, you know, grass make the grasses. Cow, they are eat grasses. Then they are give milk. By milk, you know, the production of milk, making so many kind of sweet, makhan and dahi. You know, you are eat, then you are keep your life. Then Krishna is the told, Baba, no necessary to worship to Indra. Why? This bridge, this worship deity only Giriraj Govardhan. You know, this grass is the going in Giriraj Govardhan. All kind of a fruit and a flower. Everything, you know, available this Giriraj Govardhan. If mercy of Giriraj Govardhan, you are staying in Braj. Yeah? And if Baba Krishna who think, when somebody get post of Indra, when somebody doing 100 Aswamedha Jagya, then he become post of Indra. But if somebody doing 1,000 and millions, billions of, you know, this Aswamedha Jagya, they cannot get one dust of this Braj. This Braj, not Gopi's Braj, this is the Braj Raj. He's a very, very rare. Krishna is the tone, no need. You can worship the Giriraj Govardhan. Giriraj is the fulfilled our all desire. Then Krishna is told, you are very long days you are worshiped this Giriraj Govardhan. Are you seen? Indra, are you seen the, he the accept? But when you are offering everything to Giriraj Govardhan, you can see. Giriraj Govardhan accepts everything. And he manifested and he gives benediction to you. Are your whole desire, he to fulfill your whole desire. Then Nanda Baba he became agree. Well, yes, you can tomorrow you can worship to Giriraj Govardhan. This thing is spread in whole Braj. Yeah. Then Brajavasi thinking tomorrow you are worship to Giriraj Govardhan. Everybody making so many kind of preparation, many kind of rice, many kind of chapati, many kind of bread, many kind of chutney, many kind of saag, many kind of sabji, all that like of, you know, fruits, many kind of dry food, everybody bring, you know, this name is the Annakut, kut meaning like this mountain, You know, this mountain of chapati, mountain of puri, mountain of rice, everything like this. And Krishna himself, he abhishek his own hands by Panchamrita, Giriraj Govardhan, and give tulasi leaf. And when he offered to Giriraj Govardhan, that time Giriraj Govardhan, he himself manifested. And Brajavasi, the sir, you know, this Giriraj Govardhan, how Giriraj Govardhan manifested, and what they are offering, and everything is accepted. Blessed Giriraj Maharaj Ki. Everybody said this thing. And 1 minute he finished everything. Then he told, the more bring more. Anore. So there one village name also, Anore Gram. Yeah. Then Brajavasi tell, oh Giriraj Govardhan.
Krishna told.
Krishna told. Your poor go.
Please satisfy.
Then Giriraj Govardhan. Then Giriraj Govardhan told, what is the we are want? Are you want any benediction? But they are Brajavasi. You know, Brajavasi they are only want how you can do give please to Krishna, how Krishna becomes satisfied. They are telling, oh Giriraj Govardhan, if you want to give any benediction, our Krishna always play peaceful and nice, you know. Krishna will stay very nice, long life. So, you know, then Giriraj also, he give one benediction. Giriraj is the told, yeah, if anyone give any grain of rice, even then we will never have any shortage of rice and cloth, this own life. This is the Giriraj Govardhan, he give himself this benediction. And every Giriraj Govardhan became very satisfied, all Brajavasi, you know, all became satisfied. Krishna told, oh Brajavasi, now you are doing parikrama of the Giriraj Govardhan. Every Brajavasi take Mridang and Kartar, and Krishna first start this parikrama. Now you also here, you also try to do Giriraj Govardhan parikrama. Why? You are thinking how possible Giriraj Govardhan is the Vrindavan, you are now staying Brazil, how you can do parikrama to Giriraj Govardhan? Germany, yes? Germany. So, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is the told, Jekhane Vaishnavagan, Seisthana Vrindavan, Giritatha Govardhan, Bhumitatha Vrindavan, Prakatini Sakhyat Labi. This meaning, where is the pure Vaishnava? There is the Vrindavan. There is the Giriraj Govardhan. There is the Radha Kunda Syam Kunda. There is the whole holy river. Sarvani Tirthani Vasanti Tatra Yatha Chutadara Katha Prasanga. Where the Krishna Katha going on? There, every holy river is there. Here is the, our Gurudev, he is the present here. He is the pure devotee. Yes? He is the pure devotee. Now, Vrindavan is here. And Vrindavan is here. It's the example, I am staying in Vrindavan. Dhir Krishna Puru staying in Vrindavan, Vichitrita staying in Vrindavan. Every scripture gives instruction, you can stay in Vrindavan and do bhajan. But you are still there, stay in Vrindavan. Why you left Vrindavan come here? What is the reason? Reason is the, where is the pure Vaishnava, they are not Vrindavan. Without Vaishnava, association of Vaishnava, they are not in Vrindavan. Vrindavan is they are, where is the pure day? What is the they are? Yes, so our Gurudev is here. So here is the real Vrindavan is here. And Giriraj Govardhan is here, Giriraj Govardhan. Yes, so yesterday we have heard Sthane Sthita Sruthigatan Tanumang Manabhi. So Vishwanath Chakur Thakur tell, you can stay Sthane Sthita. Sthane Sthita kya bolte? Stay the same place. He give comment, where can stay? Well, stay in, where the Vaishnava is the where? You can stay to there, only there, not here and there. Vishwanath Chakra Thakur directly he gives instruction, commentary, if somebody, Gurudev, Vaishnava, they are giving Harikatha, but they are not listening to Harikatha, not staying with Vaishnava, going every and where, holy river. No, Vishwanath Chakra Thakur directly, no. Where is the Vaishnava? You try stay to only there, not here and there. Yeah? So here is the Giriraj Govardhan. Now you are by mind, you are thinking, You are the Giriraj Govardhan. So you are by mind you try doing this Giriraj Govardhan Parikrama. First you start to Parikrama, you know, Dan Ghati. Where Krishna, he take to Dan from Braj Gopi. So your mind will afford obeisance to Giriraj Govardhan. Because it is Dan Ghati Ki. Now everybody, in Dan Ghati. After Dan Ghati, coming to Dan River Tanakunda. Where is the Braj Gopi? They are take to Dan from to Al Krishna the Sakhas. So this place name is the Dan Nivartana Kunda. Everybody take to Ashwanda this Kunda. Blessed Dan Nivartana Kunda ki. Then coming Anuragram.
It will be very long.
Now coming Anuragram. Yeah? And there is the Sankarsana Kunda where Krishna he kills Sankarsana Dakta. Then after coming Govinda Kunda. Yes. When Indra he will understand this, you know, this cow buys another ordinary person, he is the supreme personality of Godhead and he came and abhishek to Krishna. All Charanamrita in the, you know, Govinda Kunda. He also gave one new name of Krishna. This everybody take Ashman to Govinda Kunda and to pranam. Well, Govinda Kunda ki. After coming, you know, Kutsiriki Lauta and the Dan, they are Apsara Kunda and Naval Kunda, and where they all have Krishna become melted, make the Kunda. You also take Ashman to there. After the coming Ras Mandal, where the Krishna did this, you know, this Basanti Ras. And after the coming Surami Kunda, you are everybody take the Ashman to there. If somebody did some offense, anybody takes Ashman this Kunda, all offense is the move. Yeah? Blessing Surami Kunda ki. Then coming. Then coming Jatipura, where he did Madhavendra did bhajan and where he get this Gopal. Then after our big parikrama is finished, now coming small parikrama. Small parikrama, first coming Uddhava Kunda. Everybody takes the Ashman to Uddhava Kunda. But I say Uddhava Kunda ki. Then coming Radha Kunda Syam Kunda. Radha Kunda Syam Kunda is the Yes. You are everyone take prasad there. Then coming Radha Kunda Syam Kunda is the topmost place of all in her. Yeah. Radha, this is a Kunda. Radha Krishna himself they are make the Kunda. First it takes birth in Radha Kunda, then Krishna Kunda, again Radha Kunda. So our, you know, snan is the finish. Now your parikrama is the start. Then coming Kusuma Sarovar. Where Brajagopis came and collected flower, made garland and offered to Krishna. Now you have to take Ashman to there. Then Narada Kunda, then Manasi Ganga. Yeah? When all Brajavasis there want to take birth in Ganges, then Krishna by